Hello, on Thursday the 31st of August, the last day of August, and technically also the last day of summer. Our opening prayer. Loving Lord, we are aware of our human shortcomings. We ask that by your Holy Spirit you give us strength to work for that which is good, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. As the psalmist says, give thanks for the Lord, for he is good, his love endures forever. Today's readings are Psalm 19, verses 13 to 17, and the first letter to the Corinthians, chapter 9, verses 16 to 19. I receive quite a lot of requests for baptisms or christenings from people of all ages, not just relating to babies. Sometimes, as part of the enquiry, I'm asked how much the service will cost. I thank people for asking, but assure them that it's free. The service is all about becoming a member of the Christian Church. There's absolutely no way that Jesus would allow anything to take place which would prevent people from becoming members of his church because they couldn't afford it. Jesus Christ has already paid the price through his death and resurrection. St. Paul is touching on a similar issue as he writes to the Corinthian church. He's stressing that the gospel message should be shared without charge. Some of you will know that the 31st of August is also St. Aidan's Day, when we remember the life and the ministry of Aidan, who was a bishop and missionary in the north-east of England many years ago. In his role, he mixed with people from all areas of society. This included being a friend of the king. However, he is particularly known for his ministry to the poor. There are numerous stories about this told by the historian Revd. Aidan shared the gospel message, but he also supported people in need in a practical way. The practical gospel as well as speaking it. Aidan's actions are a reminder that Jesus is for all, something which we should never forget. And I'm now going to pray the prayer which is linked to St. Aidan's Day. Everlasting God, who sent the gentle Bishop Aidan to proclaim the gospel in this land, grant us to live as he taught, in simplicity, humility, and love for the poor, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in unity with the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. For today's prayer points, pray and give thanks for all the people who have brought and shared the gospel in this country. Pray for everyone who is a member of a church which is named after St. Aidan. And pray that the poor and marginalised are valued as people and not overlooked. The Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom,